Can animals in the ocean hear? When we speak, our vocal cords create vibrations. These vibrations travel to our ears, where we have three little bones that can detect these vibrations. Our brain will then interpret this as sound. In water, vibrations travel faster and easier. As we can see here, the vibrations are traveling through the water. Fish may not have noticeable ears like us, but hearing is very important. They have evolved several adaptations to assist in hearing. They have otoliths, ciliar nerve hairs, a lateral line, and swim bladders that can help in hearing or making sounds. Some fish have all of these, and some may only have one of these adaptations, but all fish respond to sound. The lateral line can detect vibrations in close proximity. This can be interpreted as sound or touch, but it assists the fish when they are schooling together, or even be aware of nearby predators. Most fish have swim bladders. The main function of the swim bladder is that it helps in buoyancy, but it can also serve as a pressure gradient sensor. It can also tie into the inner ears of the fish, which consists of dense set of bones called otoliths, which are similar to the bones in our ears. We now know that fish can hear sound, but did you know that fish can even make sound? The Garibaldi, for instance, can make a clicking or a thumping sound as a warning to anyone or anything invading its territory. As I was taking this video, you can hear the Garibaldi making those sounds to let me know that I was not welcome. Let's listen in. Can you hear the sounds? They make these sounds by grinding something called their pharyngeal teeth. The sound is then amplified by their swim bladder. Since I did not leave, the fish let me know that I was definitely not welcomed. So we learned that animals in the ocean have the same senses as us, but they have adapted to use these senses underwater. Fish are absolutely amazing animals, and we hope to see you soon visiting all of our animals at the California Science Center. Thanks for watching!